Halo, I'm here with a Mega Construx large scale buildable needler. I got this from Target for $50 US, 50, but I believe its standard manufacturer suggested retail price and its base price is $60, 60. Comes with 920 pieces. Let me take it into the other studio and show you some of the details up close and then I'll come back here. First things first, this is not a life-sized, you know, correct in-universe size one-to-one scale model. I think it's one half sized. It might be a third, but I think it's one half. The length is listed at 35 centimeters or just a little bit less than 14 inches from tip to tail. What would you call that back there? But it's pretty impressive on display, especially with the bright colors. Here's my handy classic EOD, not the newer style of figure, so just a little bit shorter than the modern figures, but it's what I had handy here. You know, so it definitely catches your attention when you walk into a room, and the color with the purple is nice and consistent. It's the classic purple color that they've used for a lot of the original Halo Wars Covenant vehicles before. The pink color that they use for the needles is interesting. It's a little bit different from what I'm used to, just compared to other things in the toy and collectible world, not to mention amongst brick-based construction systems. This has a little bit more yellow in it. So it doesn't look as magenta as I'm used to seeing for Transmake. I don't know, it's just interesting to me. Definitely has a real day glow effect to it. Around the edges, you get to see some light really collecting, and it almost feels like it's illuminated when you're in a space that has some available light. As you can see, the needles themselves are not pointed, they're just tiles, but I think it's set up pretty nicely. The build experience for this thing was interesting. I built it live over on Twitch, and at several points I didn't know exactly what I was building, because you do a number of larger sub-assemblies, you start to put those together, and then everything gets assembled, and then you start putting on detailing and cladding on the outside. And yeah, it's just a little bit unexpected, and of course it's Mega Construx, not the leading brand, so they have more different types of pieces available, which is very good, like very reusable pieces in just more shapes than you may be used to. Also, down here we've got the plaque, which says Halo Infinite on it. So that is a print over there. The other side just says Needler, also a print, two separate pieces. Those are actually hollow. There's one thing that's definitely off on with this design for the sake of accuracy, or compared to what you need for accuracy. The grip right here is very vertical, and it doesn't have a trigger on it either. So that just isn't quite right. No matter what version of Needler you're going for, except maybe, what was it, Halo 2? Like something relatively early had a completely different design than this, but anything Halo 3 and beyond that's a little bit closer to how this looks is going to have a forward raked grip, and then also a trigger guard, or a round insert for where you stick your trigger finger through. And this is missing both of those features, unfortunately. Up here at the emitter end, it looks pretty good, and they use more of the transparent pink pieces, and I'm pretty happy with that. But the main thing that I need to do in this review really is go back to the other space and show you this thing in my hand. All right, so the most important thing is wieldability. And I'm happy to report that this is plenty strong to grab and wield, just like the energy sword that they did. When you pick it up, by default, the stand comes with it, but the connections between the weapon and the stand are very few. It's three studs. There's one stud up at the front and two at the back, but somehow it actually connects really well. The clutch power and the mechanical grip in there is really good. In this case, I just unfortunately, or accidentally, got the little clear piece to come up, and just put that back. There's just one clear stud here and a clear 1x2 over here. But yeah, totally wieldable. You don't want to mess around with these things a lot. The needles can be adjusted in their angle. They can also be knocked off pretty easily, because they're only just attached with a single clip, and that clip itself can be rotated because it's just inserted with a single bar. But I mean, I'm a 6-foot adult. I do not have small hands, and I'm able to wield this fairly comfortably. There are a couple of slopes on the back here that feel just a little bit sharp at the edges, but overall, this feels pretty good to me, and you can really move it around, and I'm not worried about it coming apart because I know how it went together, the assembly process for putting the different major sections of it together were pretty sturdy. So overall, I'm pretty happy with this. The price, the full retail price of $60 feels like a bit much, but not super overpriced. I mean, I still would have gotten it. I got it for $50. I would have spent $60, and I still would have been happy with it now at that price. So overall, I'm pretty satisfied with this thing. Happy to add it to the collection in room 117. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.